ni mafamilia, watu wengi kutoka sehemu mingi wakituomba nafasi to just get a bed and oxygen. Which simply means, as a nation and also as a county for myself, we have to change our approach to how we are responding to this disease. Tukitaka transfer, if it is complicated and you want to take a patient to Nairobi, all the ICUs are full. So I want to take this opportunity. If you forget anything, please do not forget that we are now on a different stage in terms of our preparedness. Na katika vaccination ambayo tumepatiwa kupitia national government, tumeanzisha na kupatia our medical frontline workers. Na tulianzia jana, na pia tukimaliza, we will be able to profile the other high-risk categories, those who must be out, including the elderly where it is allowed, so that we can be able to make progress. But I really want to urge the people of Nakuru, and our leaders, me included, that it is also true that because of our political activities, we have created opportunities where the disease has had an opportunity to be spread from one person to the other. So we must review what we are doing, appreciate that now we are at a different stage. And for me, I would think this is probably the stage envisaged in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, 1 to 8, where we say, there is a time for everything under the sun. There is a time to fight, there is a time to come together. We cannot be as a nation when we are under such serious threat, we continue to work as if it does not exist. So my prayer and my wish, all of us from the political divide, us in the devolved units at the national level, including also the National Assembly, to do everything possible to ensure that we have resources to avail the vaccination and that they reach the intended people within the shortest time and within reasonable time. And I think for us, we will work everything possible to make sure that happens. Lastly, allow me to mention on the issue of violence or electoral violence, we say violence begets violence. And we should not condemn violence when it goes against us, and when it favors us, we clap. The reality is there was violence in Msambweni, there was violence in London, there was violence in Kakamega, in Kisii, and all those places. And therefore, we must agree, because it is inevitable that there will be other elections, because it is inevitable that politicians will want to come there. Why don't we give people, we campaign, after we have campaigned, we keep off and let them come and decide for themselves. So I think this matters that Parliament needs to guide us, sit together, and let us not imagine when violence is in my favor, I don't talk. When it goes on the other side, then I become a victim. The truth is, voter bribery and violence continue to be a major determinant of how elections go. And that is not the Kenya we want. I believe that the people of London, Nakuru, and Kenya are wise and capable of making the right decision. So give your policies, we let them decide, and we must appreciate that there is life beyond politics. That politics is not everything. For us as politicians, it is do or die. It is life and death. But for the ordinary people, there are other more pressing issues that they have to deal with. So I want to end it there. And once again, to thank all of you who have come to condole with the family of Kimani. You have come in our hour of need. And we also appreciate that gesture. Allow me also to confirm that the president, when the information reached him and he was aware that we were having a fundraiser on Saturday, he did send his contribution. And I want to say on behalf of the people of Nakuru, we appreciate that contribution, and indeed, it is a symbol that there is time for everything. There's time to compete, and there's time to mourn when our son has gone to rest. Thank you, and may God bless you. Allow me to take this opportunity to request you to be upstanding as we invite our Deputy President, His Excellency William Samoei Ruto.